remember this slipper from my beach trip, La Playa? Part of why I bought this slipper is because it has a pina colada recipe on it, and I just thought that was really fitting for the summer season. So now we're gonna actually make it, okay? And I've been meaning to make this, you know, 2 weeks ago at the very start, like the official day of summer. But as you know, my mom needed me to visit her, I guess. So we're gonna make it right now. And here we have white rum, pineapple juice, coconut milk, cream, pineapple, and ice. I don't drink, so the white rum is gonna be crossed out of here. We're gonna make virgin pina coladas. So everything else I do have, and we can get going on. I'm gonna eyeball it. ml of coconut milk. This is the can of coconut. Coconut milk! I have coconut water, but I also got this, you know, sweet condensed coconut milk. I got it for a whole different reason. Yeah, let's go. Let's use this instead. Thank goodness I got this. Let's get some ice. I gotta crush this up some more. Give me a second. There we go. Now we're getting somewhere. Oh damn. I also have pineapple chunks. And I don't think it intends me to use pineapple chunks in the recipe. I think this is gonna be garnish. I tried to find some cream of coconut. I can't find it anywhere, which is what I got this for. But now that I'm learning I need coconut milk actually, not cream. Whatever. I'm gonna use milk. Kill me. This is... Oh no! I think this is spoiled milk. No! I put spoiled milk on. Oh no! Disgusting. Let's go. Let's go. Woo! Woo! I can put in pineapple chunks. Okay. So it doesn't say sugar, okay? We're gonna do it now. I think it was too much sugar actually. Let's do it. Okay, that's it. Very good. I believe I messed up. I think the pineapple juice and the pineapple was enough sugar. And I think later I'm gonna tell you why so much sugar is not gonna be good for me in a few years if my nurse mother, my registered nurse of a mother, is anyone to go by about my health. But yeah, very, very good. Okay, happy summer 2024. This is my mom's old computer that I brought home from my visit to her place. I brought it home remembering it being broken. Like, I brought it home thinking, okay, well, eventually when I have the funds, I have to take it to a place and get it fixed. That was the impression that I have. When I was studying it, I was thinking, okay, well, what happens when I plug in my HP charger into this one? It worked out. It charged. It's on. I'm in. This is working. So now I'm thinking, why did we dispose of this one? This computer is huge, by the way. It's so long. Let me get my red one. Okay. You see this? This is my red computer that you've seen me got recently, in the recent months. This is large. This is grande. And it comes with an SD slot, which was my biggest disappointment with getting this one. And check this out, check this out. Let's go. Let's go. DVD. DVD. A laptop with a DVD player. Do they even make those anymore? I wouldn't know. This has no excitement or relevance to you guys. I'm sorry. I'm just really, really happy, okay? I'm just happy to have the two things that I like. Hi, it is the 3rd of July, and look what came in the mail. Okay, so I am not sponsored by Book of the Month. I was basically trying to get a certain book at a cheaper price, like on Amazon or Kindle. It's like $14 to $19. And from the time where I first spotted it and to now, it's not like a huge bestseller. And that's why it has gotten increasingly expensive. And I knew Book of the Month was offering it for
I think I initially saw it for $8, right? But when I went back, it was $10. And you know what? Shoot, let me just get it. And I feel like in trying to get it, I accidentally signed up for Book of the Month subscription. So next time, they're going to try and get me for, what, $16? And I might go along with it. I might not. But I'm excited to have my book. Here. The Familiar by Leigh Bardugo. I haven't purchased a hard copy book in a very, very long time. And not just a hard copy, right? But like a physical purchase. I've been doing digital to save the trees, but even now, digital has become like less and less sexy. What's this? Because I realize that you're not exactly owning, you're owning the licensing. And that just won't do. And that's why I might stick with Book of the Month and start being a physical owner. Usually I would put it here, but I don't like that anymore. I think I'm gonna put it right here. Okay. Genosha's copy. So I'm in the Dollar Tree looking for some DVDs I can get for the DVD player on my computer. Hopefully DVDs that I can, that gives me the option to play it in Spanish. See, it says language English right here. But are all of them language English? Or do they have a Spanish version for me? With subtitles? Because that's what I'm trying to learn. It says just English, English, English. I don't think I can find Spanish. This is what I got from the Dollar Tree. I got Paranormal Activity 3. In the back here, there's a Spanish dub and subtitles. Okay. The Lego Movie 2, which is very exciting because I saw Lego Movie 1. I absolutely loved it. And this one absolutely, from what it seems, comes with Spanish dub and subtitles. Okay. This is not a movie. It says Winter Log Fire, and it features many all-time favorite Christmas carols. Options to turn off or on the log fire sound, carols, or sing-along lyrics. And I just thought it was funny. Okay. I think I should open this first and see what it is. The ideal for me was going to be a Princess Disney movie, okay? So once I got these, I was like, let me go to Walmart and see if I can get a princess movie, which is like Cinderella or Snow White in Spanish, okay? Just a DVD that can also has a Spanish dub, because that would be so cute. And I could watch that over and over and over and over again, you know, for learning material. So there's no princess movie. Like, Walmart just has no DVDs at all, okay? It's barely anything there. But I did pick up House of the Dragon Season 1. I have not started watching House of the Dragon. I've been watching YouTube videos about it, okay? People just spoiling what happened. I've been keeping up with the plot storyline through there, but this is an opportunity to actually watch it. And also appreciate the Spanish dub and subtitles. So there's that. And I guess that's way better, I guess, in a whole movie.
Se movía sobre la faz de las aguas. Y dijo Dios, sea la luz, y fue la luz. E hizo Dios la expansión y separó las aguas que estaban debajo de la expansión de las aguas que estaban sobre la expansión.
I promise I've been trying my hardest to be less of a notebook junkie, but when I was leaving the Walmart yesterday to buy the House of Dragon CD, I also got these notebooks, and they were just... They were sitting there right outside of the Walmart in all these assorted colors that just remind you of summer, you know? I had to get them. I had to get them and have them be the mascot, I guess, the avatars of my Spanish learning, if that even makes sense. I have this goal that by the end of summer, or at least until I take the A2 Delhi exam in October, I just have all these filled up with Spanish practice. I think that's very exciting for me. And now that I have stated it on this vlog, now I have to make it happen. Libro de notas verde. Libro de notas rosado. libro de notas naranja, libro de notas, I forgot the word to purple, libro de notas azul. Libro di texto.
Without research, without researching.
Libro de notas mojado? Mojado. M-O-J-A-N-D-O. Morada!
Morada.
Morada.
So, a long overdue update on mi plantas. Okay, this is my eggplant, and I'm happy with where it is. This, I had it in an area where a bug was eating it, so that's quite annoying. So I moved it down here, and it's just here getting some sun. I've completely lost track of how many weeks this is, but we're seeing, I am worried about the discoloration. I'm going to have to research and write down what apparently that means. But that's where I am with the eggplant. And I guess to have it grow even more, I'm gonna have to move it to something else. But then that's just like, what can I get that's inexpensive? This is also my basil, and my basil is sick. I'm a horrible plant mom, I'm sorry. I basically need to switch them out of this container. Listen, in my bathroom, I am running out of soap, so I have to make more. And I really want to try making some rose soap. Okay, so what I did is I got a bouquet of roses, like a tiny, cheap bouquet of roses. I'm going to try and dry the rose petals in my air fryer. Okay, and see if that works out. Nice and smooth. Ooh, that's so sexy. I'm sorry.
And we're done. Look at my soaps. I left this one out to use now. And these I'm just gonna put under the cabinet to use later. If you made it by the end of this video, thank you so much. I'll see you in the next one.